Yes, Miss Grimshaw.
Mr. Matthews gave me a message for you. He said when it was convenient to head into Emerald Ranch. He's looking at a few business things there.
Okay.
Oh, he'll find something, too. He always does. Will you be well now, Mr. Morgan?
I'm always well, Miss Grimshaw.
Interesting way of putting it, Seamus.
No doubt. I do interesting very well. It's trusting I don't do so well.
Oh, please. Arthur.
This is Seamus. He's our new partner.
I ain't no such thing.
Prospective new partner, if he likes us.
Liking ain't the problem. Trusting is, as I said. Keep your voices down. I don't want my boss hearing. This is a sideline.
Of course. Look at us. Honest as the day is long.
Exactly.
I'll tell you what. Let us prove ourselves.
Prove ourselves? To this clown? What you talking about?
Good day, Hosea. Good luck with your business dealings.
Listen, he's rough and ready and quick with his tongue, but I swear you can trust him and trust me.
I'm an old man.
You're not old, Seamus.
I'm old enough. And you know why I ain't dead?
You don't trust idiots.
Exactly.
We're not idiots. Let us prove it to you.
Okay. I'll tell you what.
Arthur!
Old Bob Crawford and his boys just bought a beautiful stolen stagecoach from upstate. It's in their barn. Now, you go get that, and then we can work together.
Who's old Bob Crawford?
An acquaintance of mine.
So you want us to take out your competition?
Well, he's not just an acquaintance, but a cousin. By marriage, I also want to see if you boys got what it takes. Now, you survive that.
Where is he?
Well, he's in a farmhouse just northwest of here called Carmody Dell. It's just up the train tracks as you're heading up towards Fort Wallace. There's also some money in that house, but that's your business, not mine. But don't kill nobody. Folks know we ain't intimate no more, and they'll know it was me.
But you're fine with us robbing your cousin.
By marriage. And yes, I'd love it.
You heard the man. Let's go rob his cousin.
By marriage.
Really? Lead the way. He said the place is just northwest of here.
Me?
You're the one who's been out gallivanting around here.
That's what you call it. Oh, clearly you've recovered from your bear encounter.
Could have played that better, couldn't you?
Thought you wanted me here to show some strong arm. That's usually how it goes.
Yes, but you know how this works.
Come on, Hosea. That feller's a joke.
And that's why he's perfect. He won't cause us any problems. A safe spot to fence wagons and coaches, that's easy money for us.
I guess you're right.
Come on, it's not like he's asking us to rob a bank. If the two of us can't steal a stagecoach from Seamus's old crooked cousin by marriage, we should hang up our hats now.
So what's the story with that Emerald Ranch? You find out anything else?
A little. Owner's a nasty type by all accounts. Seamus is sure scared of him.
That's not saying much.
Something strange about the place. Used to be a saloon there, general store. Now it's all closed up, but they seem to have money.
Sounds worth a look around.
For sure. Seamus also mentioned the rancher's daughter a couple of times. How he used to see her around all the time, but now she never leaves the house? Probably just sweet on her.
That what you call finding out a little?
Don't drag this out. Let's go! Once he opens up, seems Seamus does like to talk. Hey, let's keep it down now. We must be close. That must be the place up ahead. We should go on foot from here. Let's see what we're dealing with. Come on.
There's the house.
I see the barn in the back. Stagecoach has to be in there. Okay, let's take a quick look at the place.
You see anyone?
Nope. Okay. I reckon we could do it now. Sneak in, I'll get the coach. You can try the house. Or wait until morning, when I'll head over, distract them by putting on a little show. While you sneak into the house, find what you can, and then get the stagecoach. What do you think?
Let's do it now.
All right. I reckon we're ready. Let's go. Maybe take a peek through the windows before you go in. Make sure it's all quiet.
Get on, dear boy. Everything we needed.
And I'm pretty sure they never even knew I was there.
Best way. Less problems, the better right now. Just need to get this back to Seamus in one piece, and it's a good night's work. Take it easy, Arthur. So what were you able to lift from the house?
A few bits and pieces. Nothing too fancy.
Well, we need anything we can get right now.
This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly, anyway.
No doubt. I won't forget that in a hurry. You're gonna crash if you don't slow down.
I'm looking forward to your retelling of that one around the campfire.
It wasn't the first time Mr. Matthews had stared death in the eye. And as usual, he did not flinch.
Yeah, exactly. How long you think we're gonna stick around here for?
Slow it down a bit. Not sure. Till we can't, I suppose. Okay, here we are. Just pull the coach into the barn there. Hello, Seamus. We met your cousins.
How was it?
Fine. Nice people.
Park that thing in here. Quickly. Nice work, Hosea.
It was mostly Arthur. Like I said, coarse but competent.
Here.
Thank you.
If you find any other coaches that need selling, I'll see what I can offer you for them. But discreet, you know.
Of course.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
I'm heading back to camp, I think. You coming?
Sure.
Watch you die, Morgan.
Help! Mr. Thomas Downs?
Yep, that's me.
You owe me money.
No, I'm...
We ain't a charity, Mr. Downs.
I said I would get the money, and I will. Just, I can't for a while.
Really? Threaten me, would you?
Please, I have a family, sir, please.
I don't care about your family. Why'd it have to come to this, huh?
Believe me, sir, I didn't want this either. You have to be more reasonable.
If I'm here, there's a reason I'm here.
This is not forgiveness of my debt. This is just a stay. Be reasonable.
You borrowed money from my business partner, Herr Strauss. You owe him. You took the money. He wants it back. What's not to understand? Where's our money?
I don't have it.
Sell your place.
We already owe more than it's worth.
Then sell your wife, or your family, or something. We ain't your idea of charity. Is that clear?
Thomas!
What are you looking at?
Thomas!
I said, what you looking at, woman?
My husband isn't well. If we could just have more...
Like I said, we ain't nobody's idea of charity. Get us the money.
How did you get on?
Not so good. He's almost dead. And they seem more or less destitute. You were a fool for lending them the money.
Well, people who aren't desperate don't seem so interested in my propositions.
Of course.
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see. Mrs. Linton? A caller for you.
Hello, Arthur.
Mary?
I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's-his-name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been... you've been made a widow and you come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Ah, okay.
My family... I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? You want me to help them?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but... But I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is
it? Somewhere out near Carmody Dell, I think. The rancher there said he'd seen him around the Cumberland Forest area. I just want him back, Arthur. If you find him, bring him to me at the station.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll owe you.
You already owe me.
Rediscovery of theology.
Gentlemen!
Shell of safety.
Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. Path to truth.
Well, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I don't know about this nonsense. Let me speak to the boy.
Dut-dut. Are you always this negative and antagonistic, sir?
Only when dealing with idiots. Now let me talk to the boy. You really want to do this the hard way? Goddamn lunatic!
Get off of him! That's enough, Arthur!
Kid, come on! This is crap. You're better than this.
Better than what? Better than one in paradise?
Better than thinking these fools know a damn thing about paradise. Now let me take you home.
You're a sad man, Arthur. You're a real sad man.
Sure, but come home.
No, not a chance! Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help!
Damn it, we gotta do this the hard way!
I don't have to answer to you! Sorry!
For Christ's sakes, Jamie, just hold up a minute! They're just using you! Telling you what you wanna hear!
What the hell do you know about it, Arthur?
Yeah.
I was doing just fine by myself!
Sister's worried about you.
You pop up out of nowhere?
Come on, you ain't stupid. You can see this is crazy.
You're the crazy one.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, boy. Just stop. Let's talk about this.
This is none of your damn business. I'm a man now. I found something. A calling.
You're just a kid. You're making a big mistake.
I'm not taking advice from you. You're an outlaw. You leave me alone. They're good people. I'm warning you, Arthur Morgan. Leave me alone.
Please, kid. Put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
Now calm down! Go see your sister.
Okay. Okay.
It's okay, kid.
Have I been a terrible fool, Arthur?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know, there ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Oh, no. That's all a long time ago, son. Idiot.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you. You didn't try to kill yourself.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Chelonia, though? Really? You'd fall for that?
They were very nice to me. They're decent.
I'm sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to believe that there might be something good coming my way one day. Guess that's dead in the water.
With the turtles.
Shut up.
father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore.
Forgive me, but your father's a bully and a coward. Don't listen to him.
Hey, don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's a good father? Nice man?
He won't be happy I saw you.
Well, please send him my worst regards.
The thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Come on, that ain't true. Tell me something you like. Don't think too hard.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Okay. I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something, but all right, go work in an orchard then.
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did.
Hey, are you still with Dutch and, what was his name, Hester?
Jose, yep, still the same, sort of. Here we are. She must be waiting inside.
These days ain't short.
What's with you then?
Make it quick or I might run off again.
Jamie! Jamie! Oh, come home, please. Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed. But I'll come home for you.
My boy. My sweet boy. Come on. Oh, Arthur. Thank you. Thank you.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur. And you. Oh, you'll never change. I know that.
I feel like the luckiest man alive, and I feel like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else alive. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow I imagine I shall.
How'd you do?
Hello, sir. I've come from Blackwater. I'm on the trail of a dangerous gang, Como Driscoll. Heard you had some sort of incident.
We don't deal with bounty hunters around here, son.
I was just wondering if I could get a description.
Well, they weren't friends. They got in a fight, two men got killed. Now, one of them's an idiot, the other's some kind of dumb mick, so maybe them's your boys. You can look right enough when we hang them.
Thank you, Sheriff.
Let me out of here, you maggots!
Arthur! Arthur!
Hello, old friend. Had a good time, did you?
You going to get me out of here?
I ain't decided yet.
Real funny.
Well, I ain't joking, cowpoke. I heard so much bluster out of your mouth these last 6 months, and now I got an opportunity to watch you be silenced.
Well, you gotta do something.
Why?
I always looked up to you, Arthur.
Well, that's your first mistake. Listen, there's one little problem. There's only one of me, and there's a whole town full of people wanting to see you swing.
You got to do something, Arthur. This wall just needs some good forcing.
Yes. Hook that over the bars. See if you can pull them off.
What a modern disaster this is gonna be.
Just pull that lever. Come on.
Get out of here, come on. What the hell are you doing?
He wasn't O'Driscoll.
I knew you were scum the moment I laid eyes on you.
See you in hell! Come on, Arthur!
They can't get away with this!
Let's get the hell out of here.
I got unfinished business. Trust me, Morgan.
Trust you?
Let's get out of here.
You have finally
Keep
lost your damn
Arthur.
Mind. Goddamn maniac. Should have left you to hang.
We're in it now, Morgan. What do you want to do? Now'd be a good time to shoot.
That son of a bitch is a dead man.
It's Norman.
Oh. You always was a letdown, you fat sack of crap. Excuse me a minute, Arthur. Hello, Maddie. Did you miss me? They had something of mine. My guns. I showed him, and I'll show.
some good shooting, Morgan. Whew, I gotta hand it to you.
What the hell was that you pulled back there?
Got a bit wild, all right.
Wild? Making a house call in the middle of all that?
Ain't much I care about more than those guns.
That much is clear. Who was that fella?
Skinny? Yeah, we ran together for a while. Did a bank job down south. Didn't end well.
I saw how it goddamn ended.
He was gonna let me hang.
I'm starting to wish I had. And you owe Lenny, too. If he hadn't found us in time...
Yes, you will all be thanked profusely, I promise.
Yeah, well, you're lucky Dutch has got your back. Some unknown reason.
I think we finally lost him.
Well, I hope so.
I'm giving you a holster. My way of saying thank you.
And thank you. There I was, having a dull day only for you. To liven it up by letting me help you shoot up half a town.
You're a funny fella, Arthur. Real funny. Why you act all sour all the time?
Yeah, well, you ain't funny at all. So why you gotta act like the court jester?
All right, listen. I'm sorry, but we're family now. Arthur, you and me. Sons of Dutch makes us brothers. Sometimes brothers make mistakes. I'm heading back to my little camp round back of Strawberry. Come see me. Maybe I can make things up to you.
You ain't heading back to Dutch?
No, I've been a bad boy, Arthur. I ain't seeing Dutch till I can bring him a peace offering. Bye now. Yeah.
How many?
A lot. Uniforms everywhere.
You see Sean?
No, I don't think so.
Damn it. Where's Trelawney?
Who knows?
Just keep your eyes open.
I am.
Hey. Where is that little Irish bastard?
I'm not quite sure. Trelawney's off trying to find out.
Has anyone been in the Blackwater, see how things lie?
Place is crawling with Pinkertons, bounty hunters, pictures of Dutch and Hosea.
We got a lot of money sitting in that town.
And that's where it's gonna remain for now.
Why haven't they hanged Sean, I wonder?
I think he's bait. Well, they want to trial him publicly.
Gentlemen, Sean is being moved up the Upper Montana. Then to a federal prison out west.
Damn. Well, we can't be rescuing people from some federal prison. We either rescue him now or cut him loose.
We're not cutting anyone loose.
Of course not.
Ike Skelding's boys are moving him to a camp nearby before handing him over to the government.
So, I guess we need to stop them before they get to camp. Charles. Why don't you head up on the north side, and then we'll head up on the other side of the valley and meet you. That way we have them in either direction. Javier, Josiah, come on. Let's go see.
You know, Arthur, the government, or people whom the government like, seem to be very angry.
Sure. Well, we'll rescue Sean, and then we'll get ourselves lost, good and proper. It's a big country.
I hope so.
Hmm.
let's see if we can track down this boat.
Keep your eyes open for Pinkertons. They got patrols out all over this area.
Yes. South of the river, West Elizabeth isn't a very welcoming place right now.
Down there. Reckon those might be our boys.
All right, gentlemen. Follow me. Keep your guns away until we know it's Sean, okay? I know what you two are like.
You think they can see us?
If they can, we're just three fellas out on the trail. Act natural. We'll be fine.
So, you've been gone for a while.
Much as I love dodging the law and sleeping in the dirt with you derelicts, I do have other business to attend to.
What happened in New York?
You know how life is. Never a straight road anywhere.
Especially with you.
Nice to know I'm missed, though. Have you run out of people to rob?
Oh, we'll never run out of people to rob.
But without me, you'll not find the caliber of victim that I find.
Maybe. Anyway, we should keep it down.
Come on, let's keep them in sight.
You all right, Javier? You're quiet.
He hasn't stopped talking since we left you in Valentine. It's the longest ride of my life.
Cute, dear boy. Very cute. Push up, come on. Apparently, there's a camp somewhere around here where the bounty hunters meet and transfer before continuing out west. I imagine that's where they're headed. They've pulled into shore. Get your binoculars out. Let's see what we're dealing with here.
So who are these bounty hunters?
I don't know too much about Ike Skelton's boys, but I hear they're a big crew, and wild, built some reputation in the last year or two.
That looks like Sean to me.
Certainly kicking up enough of a fuss. Yep, that's definitely Sean.
Oh, they're giving him a decent kicking.
Well, you can only imagine the shit he's been giving them.
Oh, yes.
They're taking him up the canyon.
There's Charles on the other side. Let's go.
What about the other two down there?
I've got an idea. Follow me.
Do this quietly if we can.
Leave it to me, gentlemen. I'll go around and create a distraction. Then you two sneak across and do the dirty on them.
Okay. Get your knife ready. Keep your head down. Stay here. Okay, let's move down. Don't cross until he's got their attention. Wait here. He's still reeling them in.
Gentlemen! Excuse me. Dear brothers, my wife is taken ill. Gravely ill.
What's the problem?
It's dear Bessie. She's taken a turn.
You take the one on the left. Okay, come on. Stay low.
I'm beside myself. If I lose Bessie, I lose everything.
Oh, calm down, mister.
I can't. I'm having a fit.
Oh,
Okay, let's get after him.
A pleasure as always, gentlemen. I think you have it from here.
Come on. We got two halfway up the canyon to deal with.
Okay, lean roll those boots you got there, eh? Those are very nice. Who's the guy you got them from? Is he alive still?
Mm. Come on, focus. Oh. Focus, okay.
We're gonna have to shoot our way up there!
You stay the hell back!
Where did the son of the bitches come from?
What are you doing? You're still breathing!
Two more, look out! Here's Charles.
All good?
Wouldn't go that far.
The camp's up this way. Come on.
I'll take the left side, Charles. You go right, okay?
I guess.
Let's take these hijueputas!
Goddamn army of these bastards! How much is Sean's bounty? Maybe we should do something. Still time. Drop that bastard!
That was close! Move up! Come on! Look out! We got one shooting from the tower!
Killing me.
Let's get Sean.
Arthur. You know,
lot less ugly from that other angle, Arthur.
Come on.
Do I get a hug, Arthur? A warm embrace for a lost brother now found.
You know, nothing means more to me than this gang, the bond we share. It's the most real thing to me. I would kill for it, I would happily die for it. But in spite of all of that, I would have easily left you here to rot if Charles hadn't stopped me.
I don't believe a word of that, Arthur.
Get him out of here.
You're a great man, Arthur Morgan. The kind of young whippersnapper can really admire.
Oh, shut up. Right, we should split up. Javier, will you escort Mr. McGuire back to camp? Charles, best you ride separately. Be careful. There's patrols everywhere.
What about you?
I'm gonna see what's worth taking here. I'll meet you back there as soon as I can.
All right. Okay, come on.
Have I got stories for you?
Yeah, I can't wait.
I imagine y'all miss me a lot. But fear not, the joy's back in your lives now.
I'm sleeping, Arthur.
Did I drink all that? Oh, you're gonna catch your death if you don't get warmer clothes.
Hey, Arthur!
What you want?
Uncle told me something about a train.
What did he say?
Mary Beth overheard something about a train full of wealthy folk rolling down through Scarlet Meadows just south of the state border?
Yes.
Need help with it?
I ain't even sure about doing it.
Come on. At night, not too guarded, it's perfect.
Nah, I ain't thought it through. You know, stopping a train, pain in the ass.
Sure. But what if we could force a train to stop?
Well, of course.
We get a wagon full of something flammable, oil. Put it on the tracks. They see it. They know they either have to stop or die. Ain't no train driver wants to be cooked alive.
That is kind of brilliant. For you. That is a real idea. I think that's the first time you ever had one of them.
Shut up.
You might be the first bastard to ever have half his brains eaten by a wolf and end up more intelligent.
So we're doing it?
Yeah, we're gonna need ammunition, guns, look real frightening, and some dynamite to open up the train.
I'll get the supplies. Gotta head into town for Abigail anyway. Don't even ask. You go find us an oil wagon.
Yeah, I know just the place. They're always heading into that refinery.
There's an old rundown shack just over the border, north of a place called Dewberry Creek. Leave it hidden somewhere near there.
Let's go, boy.
Yeah.
going? You fellas get over here quick! I'll be right there. Consider this a war.
Son of a bitch!
How you doing?
Good, brother. How are you feeling?
Much better. But those mountains were gonna kill me.
I think I might have had too much fun last night.
Oh, I know.
Found a couple of things in town. Maybe some
Sean McGuire. Drag everyone under the table again.
You busy, Arthur?
John.
Let's get on.
Good. And you?
Got everything we need.
Good. I think we need another man. Charles?
I'll go get him. Meet us at the wagon when you can.
Sure.
See, Arthur? Ain't that dumb.
Next time, let the wolves eat all your brain. Then you'll be a genius.
Dutch?
Not again.
How do you do? Hello?
My husband owed you money. Here it is.
Thank you. And your husband, is he well?
He's dead. A combination of beatings and sickness did for him.
My deepest condolences, madam.
And mine to you. For all your wretched lives.
So you brought the loudmouth kid back to us.
I'm sorry. I wanted them to hang him.
Well, he amuses me. You done good, Arthur. Loyalty.
Hey, Arthur. Come here a minute.
What is it?
Can I ask you a favor?
Probably not.
Very funny. Would you do something with Jack? He seems kind of down. All this upheaval can't have been easy on the poor kid.
Why? Because I'm your preferred nursemaid?
Because he likes you, and, well, you know his father's useless.
Okay.
Thank you.
gone.
Very well. That's what I like to hear.
What you up to?
Playing.
Anything fun?
I guess.
You want to come fishing with me?
Fishing?
Sure. It's about time that you started earning your cape.
Okay.
Good. Let's go get your pole then. Now, you do have a fishing pole, don't you?
I sure do. Uncle Jose made me one.
Good. Well, let's go get it then. Go catch us some fish.
Yeah.
I'll mount up and lift you on when you're ready. Boy. All right. Hold on tight.
So, where are we going?
Just down to the river near here. You shouldn't go too far from camp.
Oh, okay.
Feeling better? I know you was a little sick.
Oh, I'm fine.
You're a brave kid.
So, just like you.
Well, I don't know about brave. I ain't much of a kid no more. Though your mama might disagree. Her and a few other women, I guess.
What do you mean?
I'm just talking silly. It's been a tough few weeks up in that snow.
I like the snow.
Yes, but not like that.
When are we going back to the other camp?
The one near Blackwater?
Yeah.
Well, we're not. This is our spot. For now, anyway. Why?
I forgot a storybook there. We left so quick.
Well, I'm sure someone can get you another storybook.
Really? When?
Well, we'll see. Got fish to catch first. Yeah. All right. This looks as good a spot as any.
Where should we stand, Uncle Arthur?
Down by the shore. Come on, follow me. First, we need some bait. I'm gonna use some cheese.
Cheese?
Smellier the better. Now, cast your line. Swing the rod back over your shoulder and bring it forward in a smooth motion. Use your wrist, not your elbow.
Like that?
That's it. Good. All we do now, Jack, is wait for a fish to take the bait.
How do I know when I've got a bite?
Well, if you feel the tip of your fishing rod just twitching, don't yank it yet. That just means one's nibbling. But if you feel a hard tug, that's a fish going for the bait, so yank hard to hook it.
You've got a bite, Uncle Arthur?
There, got him.
Pull him in!
Look, Jack, it's a bluegill. It's almost as small as you. We should really throw these smaller ones back. Give them a chance to grow up a bit.
Can I take a break from fishing? I want to make something.
Okay.
Pick some of those red flowers. I'll be right back.
Mm-hmm. You gotta stick at things, Jack.
I know.
All right. Let's see what's biting there.
Fishing sure is boring, Uncle Arthur.
I know. Boring as hell. But then, something happens. And you can get food for days.
Really?
If you're lucky. But until then, you just sit, wait, try not to worry. It's good for you.
It's good for you?
I guess.
Huh.
Got one, Jack.
I see.
Well, this is clearly the spot for bluegill.
Hey, look at this.
And what?
This necklace I made.
Necklace?
For Mama.
Sure.
What a fine young man. And in such complex circumstances. Arthur, isn't it? Arthur Morgan?
Who are you?
Yes, Arthur Morgan, Vanderlyn's most trusted associate. You've read the files. Typical case, orphaned street kid seduced by that maniac's silver tongue and matures into a degenerate murderer. Agent Milton? Agent Ross, Pinkerton Detective Agency, seconded to the United States government. Nice to finally meet. We know a lot about you.
Do you?
You're a wanted man, Mr. Morgan. There's $5,000 for your head alone.
$5,000? For me? Can I turn myself in?
We want Vanderlyn.
Old Dutch. I haven't seen him for months.
That's so. Because I heard a guy fitting his description robbed a train belonging to Leviticus Cornwall up near Granite Pass.
Oh, ain't that a little old-fashioned nowadays?
Apparently not. Listen. This is my offer, Mr. Morgan. Bring in Vanderlyn, and you have my word you won't swing.
Oh, I ain't gonna swing anyways, Agent.
Milton.
You see, I haven't done anything wrong, aside from not play the games to your rules.
Spare me the philosophy lesson. I've already heard it from Mac Callender.
Mac Callender?
He was pretty shot up by the time I got to him. So really, it was more of a mercy killing. Slow, but merciful.
You enjoy being a rich man's toy, dear.
I enjoy society, flaws and all. You people venerate savagery, and you will die. Savagely, all of you.
Oh, we're all gonna die, Agent.
Some of us sooner than others. Good day, Mr. Morgan.
Goodbye.
Enjoy your fishing, kid, while you still can.
Who are they?
No one to worry about, no one at all. Come on, let's pick up your things and get home. It's getting late, Jack. Your mother would be worried. Let's head back.
Why did you lie about where Uncle Dutch is?
Because, well, because those are disagreeable men, and I don't want them to hurt him.
What did they mean about Mac? Is he in jail?
No, I don't think so. I hope he's just fine where he is. Like I said, don't worry about them. World is full of disagreeable men. That's why you got all of us, to protect you from folk like them. Now, how about that necklace you made? You still got it, right?
Yeah, I got it.
Good. Did you like fishing?
It was okay, I think. It's a lot of waiting around.
It is.
Great. We caught a fish, and I made you this necklace.
Ain't that pretty? Not the luckiest. Did you thank Uncle Arthur?
No need. We had a good time.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Just met some folk. I better go speak with Dutch.
Okay.
Hey, you did real fine, kid.
Thanks.
We got a problem.
What?
I just met some guys out near the river. A fella named, Milton, and, I don't remember the other fella's name. Ross. Milton and Ross.
And
they are employees of the Pinkerton Detective Agency. And they know about the train, and they know we're here.
Were you followed back here?
No, they know we're near here. And they want you, Dutch. They offered me my freedom in exchange, they did.
Why didn't you take it?
Very funny. Well, what do we do now?
I say we do nothing. Just yet. They're just trying to scare us into doing something stupid. We have turned a corner. We survived them mountains. We just need to stay calm.
So you saw Pinkerton's, did you?
Saw, met, and got the full message.
What did you think?
I think we're in real trouble, but the only way out is forward.
I know. That Blackwater business seems to have finished us.
Excuse me?
You know, hair pomade.
No.
Well, if you happen to find some.
Sure, I'll buy you some hair pomade.
Mister, I never learned your name. I never did. You're like a brother, but I didn't learn your name. And I said to myself, Mickey, you never learned that fella's name. Now, you'll never see him again. And you'll be sad, like when your puppy passed, because you slept on it. What's your name, mister?
Arthur.
Arthur? My uncle's name was Arthur. Uncle Arthur, we called him, on account of his name. It's a fine name, a strong name, like a king. You could be my king, Mr. Arthur. Yes, you could.
Come on, boy.
Very much a shot. That's it.
Hey, let's talk about it. Arthur.
around.
Now, let's have a look.
My pa got killed in this here store when I was a boy. It's all yours.
And that should be good.
Do we have to go away again?
You happy to have Uncle Sean back?
Yeah, I missed him.
Well, that makes one of us.
Hello, Arthur.
Here's that, hair pomade you wanted.
Well, look at that. Thanks, Morgan. I owe you one.
I reckon we should both just forget this ever happened.
You busy, Arthur?
Not too busy. Why?
I heard about a house. Could be interesting.
What kind of a house?
I don't know. A couple fellas I heard in town, they said it was really freakish. A family local boogeymen, I guess. But they're crooked in every way.
So?
Well, so these boys thought they were sitting on a lot of cash. They're highway robbers, kidnappers, apparently. They're well hidden in the woods.
Well, sounds pretty dubious.
Of course. Yeah, it's dubious, but there ain't much risk of getting caught.
Okay, then. Let's go take a look.
Exactly. Just take a look.
It's up north, on the other side of the river from Valentine. Best way there is through Cumberland Falls, though. You know it?
Sure, more or less. Okay, boy. Let's go.
Okay, we're pretty close now. Let's stop and go on foot from here. Just up the hill this way. Follow me. There's a spot up ahead where we should be able to get a good look at the place. I want to make sure we don't run into any surprises.
Sure.
Apparently, this family's been isolated for so long, they started talking in their own weird dialect. They really don't like outsiders, especially on their turf.
Well, you just keep selling me on this job, don't you? Pretty big barn in the back. It's not a bad place to start looking. There must be a lot of people living here. A large house.
This could be in any one of them buildings, and who knows how many people are in there.
I ain't sure about this.
Well, I think we need to draw them out somehow. And I got an idea. Follow me.
All these trees, I can't get a proper look at the place.
Well, hopefully it'll make it harder for them to spot us, too.
Coast seems clear so far.
Yeah, so far.
Hey, keep it down. I hear voices. Come on, let's hide behind this shed. See if we can hear what they're saying. Just stay quiet.
Maybe you's hunt a pig this time once, Mal.
Where you been now, dude? Don't be boiling now, Pappy. I's gone but 10 minutes I was.
You can lollygag on an hour day long, cause Edie takes patrol now, don't you?
What? Oh, Edie, get all the jam!
You shut your gulper, or I'll flag her your felt, I will. You need to pull it up, boy. Up. Go guard the shed.
Go!
You understand what they're saying?
Not much of it. What we doing, Javier?
Okay. Take cover by the rock over there. I'll create a little distraction, then you jump them, okay?
What kind of distraction?
Be quiet.
Oh, so
What the hickory happened here? We got to put this out, don't you? Oh.
Hey! We got fire!
Has to be under here. There's no place else I could store it. Hey, Arthur, give me a hand here. I told you it was worth the trouble, didn't I?
Yeah. You take this. Let's split up. I'll meet you back at camp.
Sounds good. They got Bill.
What? Who has it?
Bounty men. I found their cam nearby. They got Bill tied up. I'm gonna go take care of it. Come on.
Oh, sloppy Bill.
Yeah, well. You coming?
All right. Lead the way. So how'd you find him?
He said he was going hunting. Never returned. I was able to track him pretty easily. Only a matter of time before they decide to pick up camp, head for town to collect the bounty.
Guess we're in sights again.
When are we not, Arthur?
Fair point.
What'll Dutch do?
Ain't for me to say. Doubt Bill'll like it, whatever it is.
He's a problem. We all know it.
Is that for me to say?
I think it is, Arthur.
Well, let's save his ass first. Worry about how to kick it later.
Okay, we're getting close. There they are, on foot from here. Stake out your position.
Hey, you idiots never hear of Dutch's toys? You're gonna pay for this. You have no idea what hell is coming your way.
We're shaking in our boots.
Let's take him into town and collect on the bounty. Get us some money.
Won't be long before you'll be tucked up in a nice warm cell. Then you can talk all you want.
Just in time. I owe you fellas for this. Well, I'm gonna head back to camp, find a bottle, and nurse these bruises.
Yeah. I'm headed to camp as well. Thanks, Arthur.
What's next? Well, at least it ain't your job.
Shut up, Arthur.
Yeah, your job's starting the fights. It ain't winning them.
We can scrap, Arthur. I'm just not good at homework.
I can see.
Besides, what do you care, Englishman? You've got no time for me. I tried to find you work, but then you're off cutting jobs with other folks, and your boy Sean doesn't get a look in.
Guess I don't want to get shot, that's all.
Yeah, you're a real fucking funny shit, Arthur Morgan, huh? Real fucking funny.
Calm down.
You better sleep with your eyes open.
Yeah, well, you're gonna sleep with your chest open if you ain't careful, boy.
I love you, Arthur Morgan. I love you. Come on, take a shot. Come on, take your best shot, please, eh?
Grow up.
And let me come on the raid, witches.
Raid?
Don't be playing coy with me, son. It's unbecoming. That bloody train you and him has set up. What you're doing out here, you're going to need guns, you're going to need men.
Oh, that. So Marston told you? It ain't a big show. I need calmness. If I take you, I might as well bring Micah along.
Now compare me to that oily turd again. You're a dead man.
Fair enough.
Anyway, Arthur, what's your problem with me? In fact, don't tell me. I already know. You are threatened by me.
Threatened by you?
Yeah, my youthful vigor. It intimidates you.
Does it?
It's a story as old as the hills. The changing of the guard, the fading of the light. You're toast, old man.
Okay. And what are you?
I'm the future, in all its glory.
Well, good luck. Good luck and shut up. I want to get some rest before nightfall. Wake up, you lazy sir.
What are you doing here, kid?
I'm coming, John. On the job.
I said you weren't coming.
Yeah, well, Arthur says I am, and it's his party, boy, so come on, let's go. Me and the big cheeses love it. Can't wait to slit some bastard's throat.
You sure about this?
No. Are we ready?
Yeah. Train's due through tonight.
All right, then. It's on. Charles?
I'm ready.
Gentlemen, let's go earn some money. Yep.
Hey, all the horses untethered?
Think so.
Good. They should follow on behind us.
You find a good spot, Wolfman?
Yeah. Follow the trail southwest. There's a spot that's remote, but should still give them enough time to spot the oil wagon.
They see this block in the tracks, they'll stop soon enough.
Apparently. Picks up a new team of guards at the state line, so shouldn't be too much in the way of guns to deal with.
See? This is what I mean. I disappear for a couple of weeks, and you cut me out of all the action.
Just the action that requires a brain.
Ah, you're a funny fella, John Marston. From my folks, eh? You had your feet up the whole time, playing sick, and fondling that new scar, like you're gonna buy a breakfast in the morning.
Bear left here, towards Rhodes. You don't know what you're talking about.
Stay close on this. Wouldn't want you getting scratched by a squirrel or something. That could put you out of commission for the rest of the year.
Why do you have to speak so much? It's incessant.
Cause I've still got some blood in me veins. You old bastards have forgotten how to live.
I blame you two for rescuing him.
Far too much trouble for what we got out of it.
Yeah, takes a whole army of bounty hunters to bring in Sean McGuire. And look at me now, in the gunner seat. Back in business, boys. You know, my dad always used to say...
Not the dad, please.
Not this again.
Fine. Damn you three. Sulky, angry, scarface. A right barrel of laughs. So, we block the tracks with the wagon, then jump them. That's the plan.
Pretty much.
Here's good. Stop the wagon over the tracks. Remember, these are innocent folks. We handle this right, nobody needs to die here.
Yeah, yeah.
Mr. Marston, Mr. Smith, Mr. McGuire, get over there. When she slows, order.
And you?
I'm gonna make sure she slows.
I'll do or die with you. I like it.
Get moving. Here she comes. I'm going aboard. Make that quick and join us on there.
All right, get on that train! Bastard. All yours, Captain. But go on ahead.
Everybody stay calm and don't worry, you'll get shot.
Help me.
Go! Everything you got, money, valuable.
I am adverse to conflict,
please.
My dear.
I'll do
there
anything.
You go. Let's make this quick, people, come on! We ain't leaving till this bag's full!
C'est insensé!
I ain't got nothing.
Get
wanna
robbed.
Have a little chat with Romeo and Juliet.
Everything
here.
You got.
Just put the gun down, babe. Thank you.
What's the problem here?
No, please. Don't help me!
Deal with these two, will you, Mr. M?
This is unnecessary, please.
Come on! In the bag, everything you got. Keep it coming, don't be shy.
People like you make me sick.
These two seem to think we're playing games.
I'm gonna count to three. One, two.
Come on.
Ain't worth
dying over. Tell him, Mr. M.
Damn it. Sick is better than dead, lady. I'm losing my goddamn patience.
Let's just do what he says so this can be over.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a robbery. Let's make this quick.
You boys need me?
No. You go ahead and look for the baggage car.
Tough guy, huh? You sure about that?
Why are you wasting our time?
You show this son of a bitch we ain't playing around here. Deal with this fella, will you?
Quick, come on! Come on, partner. Come on, quick!
Everything you got. Money, valuables. We ain't leaving till this bag's full.
You won't get a damn cent from me.
Let me hand you over to my friend, then.
Come on. Money now! Son of a bitch.
Come on, cop it up, people. Don't be shy. Everything you got. Let's go.
This is unnecessary.
I can handle this from here. You should check on Sean.
Okay.
Don't do this.
Okay.
What is it? You all right?
Fill the baggage car.
For Christ's sake, you ain't even taking a look yet?
Probably something in here, Arthur.
Brother, but I'm seeing double here.
That gives you twice the chance of hitting someone.
Very funny. I'm gonna have a right out lump on me head.
At least you ain't got a hole in it.
Are those tennis rackets in there? Posh bastards.
Just keep your eyes peeled.
I'm dealing. Arthur, we've got a problem. There's two assholes on horses.
How many you say?
I just see a pair of them.
All right, in that case, we're fighting. Marston, Smith, get ready.
You men come out the train now, do you hear? We said you men come out now.
There's only two of you, you fools. We got a whole lot less to lose. Why don't the two of you ride away? That way neither of you get killed. Goddamn liberties.
There's a few more of them turning up.
Man, my big mouth. Okay, let's deal with them.
Last chance.
Shit, we got more on. We got more coming from the trees. Watch it there.
Behind us. More of the bastards riding in.
Yep.
We can see what they call you, the professionals of the outfit.
Shut up.
At least we made some money. Hey, what did I get? Gotta be $100 here. Very nice.
You weren't even invited.
What now?
We still need a real big take. Enough for us to get out of here.
Was that a setup? Law turned up real fast.
I don't know. I don't think so, but I'm starting to get nervous.
Think they followed us from Blackwater?
Maybe. They found me already near Horseshoe, but I think this lot was just locals.
I hope so. I'm gonna head into Valentine, see if I can get something started there.
Good idea. Either way, we should all go it alone right now. You know the deal. Don't be followed.
Of course not, boss.
What you preparing for?
The greatest of gifts.
An unguarded stagecoach.
No, you simple-minded fool. Bison.
Bison?
Bison, from which you can get anything. There's some over on the plains, I believe. I saw a couple a long way off.
Oh. Good luck.
You want to come with me? I'll show you how we hunt one.
Sure. Why not?
Mount up, then. Let's go. You know, it was before my time, of course, but my mother used to tell me stories of how her tribe moved with the bison. They lived almost as one. When the bison went, my people went. And they were the center of all life. We couldn't survive without them. They provided us with everything. Food, clothing, shelter, tools. There was a lot of respect.
Huh. I don't remember much of my childhood, but I think my people... Well, we pretty much moved with the whiskey.
Well, my father did that too. Let's try over here, to the left. Over there. You see them all? Incredible, aren't they? We should only kill one of them. I'll keep them ringed in and you see if you can bring one down. Okay? Clean as you can.
Okay.
Skin and butcher it. Take the horns, too. It can all be used. Good job. Stow that on your horse and mount up. I want to go check something out.
Okay, let's go. All right, boy. Where are we going?
I thought I saw some scavenger birds over here. I just wanted to see what attracted them. No. Look. Bison. Shot and left for dead, it looks like.
Why would someone do that?
I don't know. But I see tracks heading in this direction. I say we follow them.
All right. Lead the way. Could it have been an animal?
No, they've been shot. I just don't know why anybody would just leave them here to rot like that. Another dead bison. on the hill to the right. Come on. Shot and left for dead again. But this one looks fresher.
There's a camp there. I'm gonna take a look. Since they left?
Bison's been dead about the same amount of time.
So what do you want to do?
They could still be in the area. Let's get up higher, see if we spot anything. This way. We should have a good view from up here. Okay. You see anything? Arthur, look. Smoke to the north. Could be another camp.
Let's go check it out.
Bastards. Just killing for fun.
You think we can talk?
I don't kill for fun. I kill when I need to. Bison. It has to be them. Come on.
Wait up.
Did you fools shoot those bison?
What's your problem?
I said... Did you fools shoot those bison?
Calm down, you black or red bastard, whatever the fuck you are.
Did you shoot them?
Yes, we did. We shot them bison. We'll shoot you too if you don't get.
What business is it of yours? What? We...
It's that business of mine!
Good God, you're crazy! Look, I got a family. A family. Don't shoot me.
Stand back, Charles. I'll get you some answers.
What the hell are you doing?
Why are you killing those bison and leaving them to rot?
I don't know what you're talking about.
God damn it, tell us or you're dead.
Oh, okay. We were paid to kill as many as we could and make it look like it was Indians.
Just kill him, Arthur.
No, please, don't.
All right, get out of here.
Just don't shoot me, mister. I got a family.
Then run away.
Why did you do that?
He didn't need to die. Maybe he'll go tell his friends now what happens to poachers.
I've seen enough of this. I'm heading back.
Okay. I'm gonna see if there's anything worth taking from their camp. I'll catch up with you later.